Today's experiment is, what is a better way to remove turmeric stains? Turmeric. And this is what I did. I took a piece of cotton t-shirt and I numbered them with the different methods in which I will try to clean them. So for instance, I have number one here. Where is number one? Number one would be vinegar. So after I wash all of these with a little bit of soap, and this is hand soap, don't use dish soap because that will actually make it a stronger stain. So just use hand soap, and I mix some turmeric and a little bit of water, and I got these stains, and I have all my products right here in which I will try to get rid of them. So the first one is vinegar, and then we have bleach, then we have fake lemon juice, which would be this thing, and then we have enzyme stick, which is this, and I hope you could see that enzyme stick, lemon, fake lemon, and ordinary bleach, and the fifth one is where I will try to clean this piece with everything that's on the counter here. And then the last one will be will be real lemon. And I actually have some real lemon, and it's I have a little bit in a melting right now out in the sun. So I'm going to get to this and see how it works. So first I'm going to I have to line the counter with a lot of plastic and brown paper bag so that you can see that. Hopefully you can see that pretty good. Okay, so what I'm going to do is take the plastic bag away, and then I'm going to put a little bit of this soapy water. See how well it takes it out. Actually, these are new stains. I didn't wait until they dried. Maybe that could be another experiment, but this is what I have. I wonder if this will work, but sometimes you don't get to the stain. And in fact, I stained my t-shirt yesterday, and I hadn't noticed it until it had already dried, so it was like too late. One of the recipes I said I followed that I found was to use dish washing soap. And when I put that into my t-shirt, it just made the stain even worse, and so I had to scramble and start doing different things to try to get out the stain. So I'm going to rinse these all off right now. So number one is vinegar. Let me put that on here right now. Some more paper towels. I actually did not have white vinegar, but I don't think it matters. So we'll try and see how this works. Enzyme. Okay, just smush that everywhere here. Oof, not good. Well, I don't know if it's good or not, but it's turning pink. So I'm just gonna wait a few minutes and then rinse these out, and then the last step is to put them in the sun, and we will see how it works. Okay, so I just brought all the patches from the sun, and here we have the results, and I'm going to show you more closely what they look like, but also I'm going to repeat the experiment on these very same pieces. So for instance, number one is vinegar. I'm going to put vinegar again and soap it out, rinse it, and put it back in the sun along with all the rest of the others, the bleach, the enzyme, and so forth. But so far I would have to say that the ones that worked out the best was number two, which is the bleach. We just have a slight peachy color stain there. and then also the enzyme, and that also has just a slight stain. And then I would say number five, everything. So number six, which was real lemon, didn't seem to do very well, nor did the vinegar, and nor did the fake lemon juice. So right now I'm going to turn off the camera. I'm going to reapply all of the cleaning ingredients. I'm going to soap them up, rinse them out, and put them back in the sun and see how that works. I'll talk to you later.
Enzyme.
Just smush that everywhere here. Hello, everybody. Okay, so here are the results. But before I show you them, I wanted to just give you a recap, a review of everything that I did, because I actually added one more step in there. So what I did initially was put all the stain on there and soap and rinse each piece. And then I put the cleaning product on each one of these squares. And I said I was going to put it out in the sun, but what I did instead was I let it dry with the cleaning product in there, out in the sun. After it dried, I brought it back. I soaped and rinsed it again. And then I did a second cleaning with each product on each one of these again. And then I brought it out and I let it dry in the sun again. And then I brought it back, and this time I just soaked and put water in it again, and then I let it dry one more time in the sun. So these are the results that we came out with. Also, I want to let you know that I made a test strip, which I thought of when I brought out my first batch. So this is a test strip right here. It has only soap and water. No other cleaning product on it. And as you can see, it didn't do very well at all. So you have to have some kind of cleaning product. The sun will not bleach it itself. So the first one was vinegar. As you can see, there is still a stain on there, slight yellow stain. So that is not good. The one that worked best was the bleach. Actually, I can't even detect any faint stain in there whatsoever. So that worked very well. That's great. The third one was fake lemon juice. And again, this did not work out very well. The second best result was with the enzyme. And I would have to say that it worked out pretty well, but there is a real very slight discoloration there. The fifth patch was the everything patch, and in the first video I neglected to use one of the cleaning agents, but I remembered it and I put it in after the camera was off. So this has everything. This actually worked fairly well. Pretty good. Not bad. And a little bit better maybe than the enzyme. And then this was the real lemon juice. As you can see, that's still yellow, and that didn't work out very well. And we did do the vinegar, right? Okay. So I would say that the best cleaning method to get out the turmeric is either enzyme stick or bleach. And I would say bleach at this point looks a little bit better than the enzyme. So there are your results, and I'll talk to you next time.